It's been a whole week with Oz TV, and I feel great. No staying after school, no cameras, and even better, no Mr. Moore. Ah, life couldn't be better. Wait a minute, is that an Oz TV crew? The way he's holding that camera, no tripod? Oh my God, these rookies, and that, why would she be laughing during an interview? Let me get out of here quick before it starts again.
All right, class, so I had a whole English lesson set up for you guys with the test and everything, but since it's Friday, we can just watch STV.
No, not STV, that crappy student run show.
So dive right in. Hollywood Hills and suburban thrills, they're you. Who are you kidding? I'm not like them. I won't buy in. Hollywood Hills and suburban thrills, they're you. Who are you kidding? Don't quit till 47. Then we'll turn it up and we'll play a little faster. Take
Hey Spartans, I'm Nick.
And I'm Ryan. Welcome to this episode of STV.
So Ryan, did you hear about Pino and his VD?
Really? How'd he get that?
Vocabulary development? I guess he reads a lot.
Oh, yeah, vocabulary. I knew that.
Ryan, you need to improve on your vocabulary.
No, I don't.
Spell don't.
O-O-O.
Man, why does Pino get all the babes? I think I'm good looking.
Janice, I'm good looking, right?
Yeah, sure you are.
I don't understand why Pino gets all the babes then.
Because he runs STV and STV gets all the babes.
Really now?
That gives me an idea.
Talk to your people, Janice.
Hey, you're Pino 95,000, right?
Yeah, that's yeah, what can I help you with, bro?
Oh, we're shooting a movie in there and something's wrong with one of the cameras. You think you could help us?
Yeah, let's go take a look.
Yeah.
Wait a minute. There's no cameras in here. Who are these guys? Who are you? No! No!
Stevie gets all the babes.
Subjugate, verb, to bring under control, conquer. Joy came up with an evil plan to subjugate Pino in order to get the babes.
Evan, here. Berto, hey, zoom back in over here. Hinman, Brian, Pino.
He hasn't been here for 5 days.
What? 5 days?
Yeah.
All week?
All week.
Pino, there'll be no more STV. What are we gonna do?
Oh no, if he looks for Pino, I won't get to take over STV and get all the babes. I need a diversion now. Got an idea.
Hey, Mr. Moore, did you hear that the Hostess Factory is going out of business?
What? Since when?
Joey, you're a genius.
Digressed, to turn aside, especially from the main subject. Joey needed more to get off the topic of Pino, and he knew he would easily digress if reminded of one of his favorite things.
Oh my God, how long have you been here?
Wait, what happened? Why are my pants? Oh no!
Well, I have to keep cleaning the bathroom, so...
Yeah, no problem. Let me leave you alone. Oh my God, I should never trust people. Joy's gonna get it so bad. Dissuade, verb, to deter a person from a course of action or purpose. Now with Pino looking for revenge on Joey, he'll have to dissuade him from killing him.
Hey Ryan, did you go to the pep rally Thursday?
No, Nick, I'm out of pep.
Did you give it all to the rally?
Yeah, I ain't got no more.
This is the vocabulary thing I was talking about earlier. Here, have some pep.
Hey Spartans, this is Thomas. We're gonna see how this pep rally went. In the canned food drive.
Team. So what do you guys think about the pep rally?
Man, it's fun. It was pretty good. Even though we lost, we got cheated though.
It's alright, even though I'm not on the wrestling team.
Next time, don't give us the freshmen, because you know the freshmen don't know what they're doing. It was basically a 2-on-1.
They suck. That's simple.
So what you think about this pep rally over here?
Well, by my definition, by the actions of this pep rally,
it was live. It was live. It was free. Awesome. It was live than a perfect jacket. It was live than a perfect jacket with the hand job, the YCMA, oh, the thriller. I was doing everything. This thing was so live. It was live.
But it was good.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
What? How was the pep rally?
What?
How was the pep rally?
It was dope.
It was dope? What does that mean? I don't speak that language.
It was fun.
It was fun?
Yeah.
How fun was it?
Extra fun.
Oppa Gangnam Style!
So Nick, what did you get last Christmas?
Nothing.
Why not?
Because no one cared or loved me enough.
Well, I see some people that really do care.
Hi everybody, this is Lady Chacon, and I'm Vice President of the National Honor Society. Every year, the National Honor Society teams up with the Salvation Army, and we bring to Hollywood Hills a drive called the Angel Tree Drive.
Hello Spartans, Joe here. Yes, the very same Joe that did the sports voiceovers, specifically for football in general. But now I have retired as a donations expert, and I observe donation events, such as the Angel Tree. Yes, that's right, Spartans. I observe donation events now. So, this is what you'll be into now, with me, as I go on a journey and tell you all about the things around us. Like, look at this. Master Tricycle Thrive 5000. Yeah, 5000. It's a great toy. Lots of buttons, lots of lights. Makes three-year-olds entertained. And then, yeah, Barbie princesses and stuff. And, well, I think the point here is that give to the children, Spartans. Don't let them have the holidays without a good toy. Because I like toys, too. Specifically, Halo 4. So if you guys could get me Halo 4, that would be nice. Goodbye, Spartans. Happy holidays. And thank you, NHS and Lady Chacon, for helping children have toys. Very delicious toys.
Hey, Nick, did you see the basketball game?
No, I didn't.
Well, let's check it out. They won.
Like always.
From the three, God, the boy let it up. This boy going in. Lay it up right in his mouth.
Oh, my.
Right in his mouth. Look at this guy. Nice.
That
pass. That was sexy. He lost the ball. Took it all the way. Fast break.
What's that is?
He should have dunked it.
It's out
here.
Give me that back.
Pass it.
He thought he
fast break.
Oh, my.
His mouth. Look at that. Oh, in his mouth. Pass it.
You thought you had it.
That boy thought he had to swat it.
Kick.
Oh my god.
Oh my. You see that? Get off me. You can't get me. You can't touch me. I'm LeBron.
They need to double team him. Double team.
Oh yeah. They did not just leave him right there.
They
did not
leave him. And it was all in there. They left him there. And that boy said, what's up?
Oh, look at this. Fast break. Get off me. Get off me. You thought
you was going to make it. You're not good,
get off me. Double team can't touch me.
All around. All those hands on there, and he still made it with the foul. Stole the ball.
Still
he fell, and it was in.
What you think
balls
he doing?
Balls up. He gets it. All in there.
Their defense sucks. They can't stop them. Yeah.
Look at the score. 44-41.
Booyah.
I think we won.
Participate in No Shave November?
You know it. Get me warm.
How warm?
Warmer than a fire.
That's not funny.
I know. Let's go see some other people that did participate.
Sounds like good.
Oh, hey there.
Oh, hey. Can I interview you?
How are you? Oh, sure. It's not like I had anything better to do, like get to class.
Oh, well, I'm sorry if I'm interrupting you, but let me ask you a couple quick questions.
Go for it.
So, how do you feel about No Shave November?
Well, you see, I think No Shave November is a very great time for all the men who have the capabilities of growing beards, such as myself and you.
Yes.
You. Yeah.
I whip my beard back and forth. I whip my beard back and forth. I whip my beard back and forth.
Well, you know, it kind of started out as Movember, when the Australians wouldn't shave their mustaches to support testicular cancer. But then No Shave November was started by a bunch of lazy college students, so now it's kind of the same thing, but it's good because it supports cancer, and we get to be lazy and not shave, and it looks awesome. Aristotle once said, trust no man who has no beard.
Those are some heavy words from Nathaniel Cavanis.
I whip my beard back and forth. I whip my beard back and forth. I whip my beard back and forth.
How do you feel?
Like a barbarian. Feels all nice, you know? Yeah.
So I'm guessing you like No Shave November.
I love it.
My beard's so thick.
There we go. Oh, look at that.
No Shave November, yeah. So sick.
Look at that, bro. She has a bona fide.
Thicker than a brick.
Check.
I grew it in a flick.
Mike.
You got the mic? Sit down, bruh. Got my beard, dawg. Sit down, bruh.
Is the mic even on?
Bruh. Turn the music up in the headphones.
Louder.
So you hear me in your phones.
Can't hear you.
Put the volume up.
Higher.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh.
I think it's a really good cause, raising awareness for cancer of the male variety.
Mm-hmm. Testicular cancer, guys. Awareness. It's good. So I see you have a mighty fine beard over there. How long haven't you shaven for?
A couple of years, actually. Just letting it grow in. It's really good.
Yeah. Do you plan on braiding it or, you know, dreading it or anything?
Nah, I like to go all natural.
Natural?
Yes, all natural.
All right.
I think No Shave November is very important. It's a very intense sport, but it can get very itchy at times.
I see you have a really nice beard there. How long haven't you shaven for?
Since November 1st.
It's only 3 weeks, and you have a pretty ginormous beard. When did you first start shaving?
When I was 8 years old. Happy Thanksgiving.
How long has it been since you've shaved?
Since like summer.
Summer?
This guy. Yeah, I was like inspired by the Zigzag Man. You know, I wanted to get my beard nice and long so I could braid it.
That's nice. I like it.
I know, it's majestic. It's nice and fluffy.
Well, Spartan, sadly, this is the end of this episode of STV.
See you next time.
Yes, we will.